it's always exciting. Put your hands together for Wendy Keelan. Say that again, I missed that wonderful intro on the video. Put your hands together for the amazing and always entertaining Wendy Keelan. Make it loud. That's what I got.
I do need a cable though.
Alrighty, so usually I get up here and put a band together and rock, but I kind of already did that on Bobby's set, so so I decided I would do two originals tonight. So for some reason, I seem to write a lot of songs for obscure holidays, like songs that people don't usually write songs for, right? And since yesterday, you know, we all know what obscure holiday was yesterday, right?
National Pizza Day.
National Pizza Day. I didn't write for that one. Let's go. Come on. What obscure holiday was yesterday?
Valentine's Day.
Ash Wednesday, right? It was Ash Wednesday and Valentine's Day. So since I get two songs, I'll do one for each. I was gonna end with my Burns Day song, which is from 3 weeks ago, but
come back next month.
I know, right? But then it will be even. Burns Day is January 25th, so I'll have to come back next year for that one. All right, so this is my Ash Wednesday song, which I did not realize until after I had written it was an Ash Wednesday song. I wrote it 2 weeks before Ash Wednesday, and then I got to perform it on Ash Wednesday. Put this where I can see it though. There we go. So, both of these songs you will discover are not actually about the holidays in question. They're both about something else, i.e., writing songs. All right. On Wednesday night at 7 o'clock, just like so many Wednesdays before, I went to play a song or two at my local music store. When my turn came to take the stage, the manager turned and said to me, "I'm sorry to inform you that there's been a change in policy. You must play only songs that you have written yourself. We can't allow you anymore to do what you have done before. And if you violate the rules, we'll have to throw you out the door. You can't play any covers at the Sam Ash anymore." Get it? Ash Wednesday. When I got home, it occurred to me, next week I'd need more songs to play. 3 songs a week is an awful lot. I'm not sure I have that much to say. I'd better get a jump on this. Next Wednesday will come before too long. Write myself another song. So I stayed up all night, wondering what to write about. I racked my brains, but nothing came, till I fell asleep up on the floor. I tossed and turned, and nightmares churned, and when I woke memory. That actually happened. I was... Other people got up and played cover songs, and then my turn came, and as I was walking toward the stage, the manager said, sorry, you can't play covers anymore. Like, they had gotten a call that their licenses had run out or something, and they hadn't paid them. So for 2 weeks, we could only play originals, and then we could play covers again. So I literally went home that night and wrote that song. All right, this is my Valentine's Day song. I wrote this for a kind of a song contest about breakup songs. And I thought, all these people are writing breakup songs, and a lot of them are about real people. And it's really, you know, I thought about all the people on the other end of the breakup song, and I thought, it's not really fun to be that person. And I didn't want to write that song, so I wrote this song. It's called Never Date a Songwriter. Don't ever date a songwriter.
Because we welcome all kinds of covers. We welcome you with your band, without your band. We'll even play a track behind you if you want to sing and you don't know anybody. Put your hands together.
I thought she was saying, I was terrifying you from dating anybody in the room.
No, that's what I was saying. You're terrified to go near a songwriter.
These people accept it, of course. They're lovely people. They would never do that to you.
And you just thought it was Taylor Swift. Be warned. Listen to what Wendy said. Thank you so much, Wendy. So, next we have, and thank you for waiting, Bob. The way the lottery works, you never know what time you're